Mississippi passing legislation to create a court system to govern only white people. Let's put up the picture here. That is the illustrious Capitol. This is where all of the legislation gets dealt with. A white supermajority of the Mississippi House voted to create a separate court system, an expanded police power inside of the blackest major city in the United States of America, the city of Jackson, Mississippi. This new court system and this police takeover would be orchestrated by a completely white panel of state officials. It is called House Bill 1020. If House Bill 1020 becomes law later this session, which by the way, many are predicting it will, the white Chief Justice of the Mississippi Supreme Court would be able to appoint two judges to oversee a new district within the city. Now watch how they're doing it. This new city, one that includes all of the city's major white communities, among other areas, this white city or the white state attorney, attorney general would appoint four prosecutors to this new dynamic within the city. A court clerk would be appointed as well to govern the white members of the Jackson community. And four public defenders would be available for the white members of this new dynamic. The White State Public Safety Commission would oversee an expanded Capitol Police Force run currently by a white chief of police inside of the black city, taking away their authority as a city government. There's more. After thorough and passionate dissent from black members of the House, the bill passed 76-38. 76-38, primarily along party lines. The bill would double the funding for the district to $20 million in order to increase the size of the existing Capitol Police Force. The new court system laid out in House Bill 1020 is estimated to cost $1.6 million annually. I'm going to help you get to the bottom of why this is even a thing, okay? Okay, let me help you out here. You got two black members of the House, Representative Cedric Sellout Burnett, a Democrat from Tenicha, and Angela Cockerham, an independent from Mongolia. They voted for the measure. Now, why do you think they voted for the measure? Who the hell knows? Maybe they were promised something. But all but one lawmaker representing the city of Jackson, Representative Shonda Yates, an independent, actually opposed the bill. The bill was authored by Republican Representative Trey Lamar. He's on the left. It was sent to Lamar's committee by Speaker Philip Gunn on the right. Instead of sending it to the House Judiciary Committee where it was supposed to go, they decided it would have a better outcome in another committee. Many House members who represent Jackson on Tuesday said they were never consulted by House leadership about the bill. Much of the debate centered around the issue of creating a court where the black majority in Hinds County would not be allowed to vote on judges. When asked why he could not add more elected judges to Hinds County rather than appointing judges to the new district, Lamar said, "This is the bill that is before the body. And we're going to vote on it." Listen, please understand what they're doing. Jackson is roughly 80 to 83% African American, but very prominent white people do live in Jackson, including statewide elected officials. The white legislative body, the primarily white legislative body, they have to govern from Jackson. That is the location of all of their legislative everything. So what are they really saying? They're saying they do not want to be governed by black people. And so they're creating a district inside of the city that will have a different standard of operation, a different court system, and a different police force than anywhere else in Jackson, Mississippi. This was actually a thing back in the 60s. I remember when the documentary of the Atlanta Police Force was shown, and it highlighted how black cops were not allowed to arrest white people. They were not allowed to go to the precinct. They had to stay at the local YMCA. They were not allowed to stare at white women. They had a badge, they had a uniform, some of them even had a gun. But culturally, they were not to engage nor govern the actions of white citizens. Even back then, none of that was codified into law. It was simply understood culturally. Literally, you have a reverse of that. It is now going to be codified in law if it is signed. My dear sister, what are your thoughts on this?
You know, we've always heard that there are two justice systems in this country. You know, we're not all playing by the same rules, and we're not all being governed by the same set of rules. Mississippi already has a less than stellar reputation, to put it nicely, in this country. And it's clear that they take pride in their racist past and their racist present. And they seem adamant to ensure that Mississippi has a racist future. You know, this is a case of a minority governing a majority. And whenever that happens, you tend to see really oppressive measures of governance put in place. If they don't have the majority on their side, they have to find ways to pacify and manage and control that majority. And that includes stifling their voices within the community and essentially taking away their rights. And the thing with laws is that there are always loopholes. Whatever somebody wants to happen usually can be made to happen within those laws. Or in some cases, you see things happen outside of the law, but if there's no oversight or no meaningful opposition, then who cares? Do whatever you want.
Yeah, so we will obviously follow this story. This is, once again, one of those places where likely it is going to act as a first of many. Okay, so we have to pay attention to something like this.